Hi, I'm Dr. Anthony Larson, and I want to talk to you about a very common problem that I see in my dental office, dentin hypersensitivity. You drink something, you eat something, you have a tooth that's sensitive, and it's just bothersome. Is there anything you can do about this? The answer is absolutely. There are a lot of good options for helping with dentin hypersensitivity. Let's talk a little bit about what that is. The dentin is the softer part of our tooth. It's still a hard substance, but it's not like enamel. Enamel is designed to be in our mouth. Enamel is very dense. If you look at it under a microscope, there's no holes in enamel. It can handle the acids and the heat changes in our mouths. But dentin, when we have some gum recession or wear or abrasion on our teeth that exposes the dentin, this dentin is much more porous. If you look at dentin under a microscope, you'll see a lot of small tubules within the dentin. And these tubules lead directly to the nerve and can cause a lot of hypersensitivity. Some patients have gum recession but no hypersensitivity, and their microtubules may not be as large or there may not be as many of them. But for someone that has dentin hypersensitivity, these tubules are the problem. So how do we address it? There are some things you can try at home first before going to see your dentist. The first thing that many people do is try toothpaste or mouthwashes. These can help with dentin hypersensitivity. You're specifically looking for certain compounds within them. Many desensitizing toothpastes have something called potassium nitrate in them. Potassium nitrate actually interacts and desensitizes the nerve. There are other toothpastes that have something called sodium fluoride or stannous fluoride in them. These will also desensitize your tooth, not by interacting with the nerve, but by actually plugging up those tubules. So if you're dealing with dentin hypersensitivity, the first thing I would recommend is find a toothpaste that has either potassium nitrate or a stannous fluoride or a sodium fluoride. Use that for a couple weeks and see if you get any resolution. I would also recommend two things as you're using it. Don't rinse the toothpaste off after you brush. Or if you do need to rinse it off, you may want to reapply with your finger just a small amount of toothpaste in the area. Using a lot of water as you brush or rinsing your mouth thoroughly after you brush will greatly reduce the effectiveness of these over-the-counter desensitizing medications. So let's say that you've tried this toothpaste and you're still dealing with dentin hypersensitivity. Is there anything else you can do? There are other options. Most of them involve going to see your dental professional. There are some in-office treatments for dentin hypersensitivity. For example, there are some different substances that can be manually rubbed into your tooth, into the dentin, that will help. Sometimes they also work by plugging the tubules or desensitizing the nerve. There's also compounds that will seal off those tubules. Fluoride varnishes, for example. And in some extreme cases where we've tried all these options and are not getting resolution, a filling might be placed over the dentinal tubules, or a gum graft could be placed to cover up the exposed dentin, depending on the situation. So there are ways to treat dentin hypersensitivity, and what needs to be done will depend on the situation. I would recommend trying some of the over-the-counter toothpastes or mouthwashes that contain these compounds we talked about. And if that's not helping, go and see your dental professional. He'll have some good options for you.